Okay, so this video is somewhat optional. I just wanted to work through an example for you that uses strings and then so by proxy uses arrays, and also shows a little bit about reading command line arguments. And I'd also like to start showing you how to use the debugger. So I would encourage you to use the link that I'll provide below to download this file and play with it, to compile it and run it yourself. But I wanted to sort of step you through the process here. So this is the program here. So I've opened it in Nano. So this is a command line based text editor. So you can see that we have some includes up here. So we're going to use the standard IO library. We're going to use the regular standard C library. We're going to use some string functions. We've gone ahead and created a preprocessor macro called stirlin. So we're going to have a string that is going to be 8 characters long. In fact, it's probably only going to have enough room for 7 characters, right? Because it needs a null terminator. So we have our main function here. It again takes an argc and an argv. We are going to go ahead and check the parameters to make sure that we're getting the number of parameters that we're expecting. So we're going to, this is a little hello world program. It takes a first name and a last name, and then it basically reformats it a little bit so that it keeps the first name and then abbreviates the last name to a single initial, and then says hello. So we're looking for 2 parameters, which means that we need a total of 3 things in argv, because remember that argv also contains the name of the program that's running. So if argc is not 3, then basically we just need to print an error message and an exit. So then here we're going to create a space for a new string. So this is where we're going to put the full name. So the first name and then a space and then the last initial. So that's the declaration of that space. And then here is the line where we actually do the string copying. And remember that we're doing this using the snprintf function. So full name is the destination here. The maximum number of characters that we can write is stirlin. So this keeps us from doing an array out of bounds, right? And then this is the format specifier. So we want a string. So this is going to be the first name. And then we want a space. And then we want the we're going to want 1 character of the last name and then a period. So the first name is going to be the second element of argv. And then the last initial is going to be the first character in the third parameter to the function. Once we've done that, then we can print out the name using the string format specifier and passing in the buffer where we've written the name. So that's what this program does. And so in the next video, I'm going to step through it in a debugger to show you how, number one, how to start using a debugger, but also to point out a few things about how this program executes and about how all the data is stored in memory.